डियर फ्रेंड्स, लास्ट टाइम वी स्टार्टेड लेसन नंबर 4, दैट इज मोशन इन अ प्लेन. नाउ वी टॉक्ड अबाउट वेक्टर. सो एज वी डिस्कस, वेक्टर हैज बोथ मैग्नीट्यूड एंड डायरेक्शन. वी टॉक्ड ऑफ स्केलर क्वांटिटीज एंड वेक्टर क्वांटिटी. वी ऑल्सो डिस्कस दैट वेक्टर ऑपरेशन, दैट इज एडिशन एंड सब्ट्रैक्शन ऑल्सो वी डिस्कस. सी, वी डिस्कस टू टाइप ऑफ मैथड. वन इज अ ग्राफिकल मैथड एंड एनालिटिकल मैथड. सी, द ग्राफिकल मैथड, we saw triangle of vector addition, also the parallelogram law. We also discuss subtraction of vectors. We discuss the properties of vector addition, that is commutative. Vector addition is commutative and vector addition is associative. Now today we see analytical method, okay, for finding out resultant of two vectors, okay. Okay, that is addition of two vectors. Later on we'll see this can be used for subtraction also. Later on we'll be able to see this can be used to subtract two vectors also. Now vector, let us say vector A, OP, okay, OQ, that is B. Okay. Now we saw that in parallelogram method, see, in a parallelogram opposite vectors are parallel and equal. So here, see, this OP and OQ are adjacent side of a parallelogram. See, the angle between A and B, now we complete the parallelogram by taking opposite side parallel and equal, that is QS. Okay, that is A. Now this PS is parallel to OQ. Okay, so OQ is B, so PS also will be. Okay, now see, these two are parallel line. This will be a transversal, so this angle and this angle will be equal. Okay, now let us say from S I draw a perpendicular. Okay, so this angle will become 90 degree. Okay, SN is perpendicular to OM. Okay, now what is the value of PN? That we have to find out. See, triangle PSN is right angle triangle. Okay, triangle PSN is a right angle triangle. So here cos theta is adjacent upon hypotenuse. Now this PS, we have seen it is a vector B. Cos theta is PN upon PS. So what is the value of PN? B cos theta. Okay. Now sin theta will be SN upon PS. That is SN upon B. SN is B sin theta. Okay. Now see here, as we have discussed in the parallelogram law of vector addition, see, the diagonal of the parallelogram represent resultant vector in magnitude and direction. So this is R. Okay. Now consider triangle ONS or OSN. Okay, that is also right angle triangle, and this OS will be hypotenuse. So OS will under root ओएन स्क्वायर प्लस एस एन स्क्वायर. नाउ सी व्हाट इज वैल्यू ऑफ ओ एन इज ओपी प्लस पी एन. सी दिस ओपी इज नथिंग वेक्टर ए, पी एन वी हैव सीन इज अ बी कॉस थीटा. एंड व्हाट इज एस एन? दैट इज बी साइन थीटा. Okay, that we have discussed. Now, let us see again. See the analytical method to find out resultant or addition of two vectors. See, OP and OQ are adjacent side of parallelogram. OP is A and OQ is B. Now we complete the parallelogram by taking QS parallel to OP and PS parallel to OQ. So this QS will be vector A and PS will be vector B. Now from these two are parallel lines. This will be a transversal. So this angle theta and this angle theta will be same. Now triangle PSN is a right angle triangle. So in triangle PSN, cos theta is PN upon PS. That is PN is B cos theta. See sin theta is SN upon PS. Okay. So SN is B sin theta. Now as we have discussed in a parallelogram law of vector addition, see the diagonal of the parallelogram represent the resultant vector in magnitude and direction. So this OS is our R. Okay. Now we consider triangle OSN. So OS will be under root ON square plus SN square. Okay. Now we see the OS is the hypotenuse. Now we substitute the values. Okay. OS is R, that is resultant. Okay, so R under root, what is value of ON? A plus B cos theta and SN is B sin theta. Now we simplify. This is A plus B cos theta square. That is identity we are using is x square plus 2xy plus y square. So that will be a square plus 2ab cos theta plus b square cos square. Now this is b square sin square theta. Okay. Now see what we can take common here, b square. So a square plus 2ab cos theta, b square is common. Okay. Now see cos square theta plus sin square theta is 1, that is trigonometric identity you have studied earlier. A square plus, now this we can write as a square plus 2ab cos theta. Now very important formula. See whenever two vectors, an angle between the two vectors is given, resultant we can find out by using this formula. That is under root a square plus b square plus 2 to b power. Similarly, for the vector subtraction, you can use a square plus b square minus 2ab cos theta. Okay, so that is a this R, this formula will give the magnitude of the resultant vector. Now, as we talked, the vector has both magnitude and direction. So, next we have to find out direction of the resultant. Now, let us say alpha is an angle made by resultant vector with vector A. Okay, alpha is the angle made by resultant vector R with vector A. Let alpha is angle made by that is alpha is the angle made by the resultant vector R with vector. Now see, we again consider triangle OSN. Okay, so what we take? See in triangle OSN, tan alpha is SN upon ON. Tan alpha is SN upon ON. Now, see ASN is B sin theta we have discussed. Okay, this value is B sin theta we have discussed. And this ON is OP plus PN, that is A. This is B cos theta. A plus B cos theta. So tan alpha is B sin theta upon A plus B cos theta. See, that is a angle made by resultant vector R with vector A. Okay, so this is how we can find out the direction of the resultant vector. That is alpha we have taken as an angle made by the resultant vector with vector A. See, this is a useful relation. Number of MCQ and numerical we are going to use. So this is about the vector addition. Okay. Now, see, in the beginning of the lesson we talked about type of vectors. Okay, we talked of free vectors, then equal vectors, then parallel vectors, then anti-parallel vectors. Okay, and aparallel vectors. We also saw about position vector. Now, next is a very important topic, that is unit vector. See, the word unit means one. So a vector having magnitude of 1, okay, is called a vector having a magnitude of 1 is called unit vector. Generally, a vector can be represented in multiple of its unit vector. Here, a vector can be represented in multiple of its unit vector. Now, see, let us say A is a vector. Now, as I told earlier, if I write in modulus of A or simply A, see here, whenever there is an arrow, that shows the vector representation. See, when I write in a modulus form or simply A, that is a magnitude of vector A. Now, see here we are talking of unit vector. So how we can get a unit vector of a given vector? See, dividing a vector by its magnitude, unit vector in direction of given vector. Okay, dividing a vector by its magnitude, unit vector in direction of given vector can be. Now, see, in form of symbol u caret. Now, this is symbol caret, or sometimes they call hat. Okay, it is up to your convenience. Now, how do we get a unit vector? See, dividing a vector, that is a vector form, by its magnitude. See, the magnitude we represent like this, or simply like this, A upon A. Okay, we get a unit vector. So dividing the vector by its magnitude, we get a unit vector in direction. Now, this is very important. See, what is unit vector? See, a vector having magnitude of 1 is called unit vector. Okay, generally a vector is represented in terms of the unit vector. See, A is a vector form, modulus of A, or simply A is the magnitude. See, dividing a vector by its magnitude, unit vector in direction of given vector can be obtained. See, by equation form is like this. Now, this will be useful to us in a number of ways. Now, see, here we have to study two dimension or three dimension. Okay? So, we talk of some specific unit vector. Now, see, our Cartesian coordinate system x, y, z. Okay? Now, see, the unit vector in direction of vector x direction is called I cap. Unit vector in direction of is j cap, and k caret is a unit vector in direction of x axis. Okay, I caret is a unit vector in direction in x direction. J caret is a unit vector in y direction. K caret is a unit vector now just now I talked I told a vector is generally represented in terms of the unit vector. Suppose we take a simple example. Okay, vector A has magnitude of 7 and it is in positive x direction. Now this is a statement form. How we can convert in equation form? So see, the symbol for A vector is like this. A is 7. Now x direction, what is the unit vector in x direction? There is I cap. Okay, so this is how this statement I can represent in terms of the equation. Or see, this is a very simple arrangement of, as I told, see, as I told ki a vector is represented in terms of the unit vector. So here the 7 is a magnitude vector and I caret shows the direction. So this is how any vector can be represented in terms of the unit vector. Now we take another example. Vector B has two components. X component magnitude is 3 and Z component magnitude is 5 and Y component has negative value of 6. Okay, now here it is in 3 dimension. So vector B, what is this x component? 3. So it will be 3 into I caret. Okay, now y component has a negative value, so actually 6 into minus I, you can say, or minus 6 into I caret. See, you see the same value, and z component is 5. Okay, so this is how vector B we can represent. X component is 3, Y component is a negative value, and Z component is plus. So this is how any vector can be represented in terms of the unit vector. Now next we have to see the addition of two vectors. Okay, addition of two vectors by analytical method. So generally any vector is represented in terms of the x, y and z component. Now see, before going for this, we can see how to divide two vectors into its component. How to divide two vectors into its component. Now first we represent component of vector in two dimension. Okay, now let us say OP is vector A. Now see, we have got two perpendicular axis x and y. Let us say theta is an angle. See, the word component projection effectiveness, all of these have the same meaning. Sometimes they shadow of the vector. Okay, now here vector is A, makes an angle theta with the positive x-axis. Now suppose I drop a perpendicular here. Okay, now let us say M. Similarly, I drop a perpendicular here on y-axis, that is M. Okay, now see this OM. Okay, OM is the effectiveness of the vector in x direction. OM is the effectiveness of vector A in x direction. This PM or OM, see this will be equal. See this OM is AX, that is x component of A. Now this will be AY. These two are opposite side of a rectangle. So this also, this ON will be AY. Okay, now as I told, any vector can be represented in terms of the unit vector. Now see, what is the x direction unit vector? I carried. What is y direction unit vector? J carried. Now see, we saw the triangle law of vector addition. Okay, now let us say, see this OM is one vector. On the head of the first vector, heel of the second vector is kept. See the third side taken in the opposite order represent the resultant vector. So what we see here, see in triangle OMP, okay, that is OM plus MP is OP. Okay, now OP is nothing but vector A. Therefore we can write OP is equal to OM plus MP. Now what is OM? Is x component. Okay, but see it is in a x direction. See what is a unit vector in x direction? I correct. What is MP? See that is AY. See that is a y component of the vector. See it is in y direction. What is the unit vector in y direction? J. Now OP is nothing but our vector A. So this is how I divided a vector A into its component. Okay, see the vector A is represented as AX I caret plus AY J caret. Now how to obtain magnitude of this component, that is AX and AY. Now see, consider triangle OMP. Okay, cos theta. Okay, that is OM upon OP. What is OM? AX. What is OP? A. See, right now we talk only the magnitude. So AX is A cos theta. Okay, now see, AX is nothing but A comp AX is shows the X component of vector A. Now suppose this angle is theta. What will be this angle? These are complementary. Why? Because 90 degree. This we can write as 90 minus theta. Okay. Now consider triangle ONP. Okay. Consider triangle ONP. Again I say cos 90 minus theta is what will be adjacent side? ON. Okay. And what is the hypotenuse? OP. Okay, now see the trigonometric result, you are familiar. Cos 90 minus theta is sin theta. So sin theta is ON is nothing but AY upon A. AY is A sin theta. This is also very useful relation. Okay, now see the component of any vector in any direction is the product of the magnitude of the vector and cosine of the angle made with the direction. See here also the same thing, cosine of the angle 90 minus theta, but see the trigonometric result we are known to us, that's why it has become sin theta. So that is how, see the component of vector in any direction is nothing but product of the magnitude of the vector. See what is the magnitude of the vector A? that is A and cos theta. So this is how we can divide into its vector, into its component. See, right now we talk of the x component and y component, there is component of vector in two dimension. Now suppose we are given the components and we have to find out the resultant vector. See, that also is possible. Okay, now see our result. Ax is a cos theta, so cos theta is ax by a. Similarly, ay is a sin theta, sin theta is ay upon a. Now recall the trigonometric identity, cos square theta plus sin square theta is 1. Okay, that is ax upon a whole square. Okay, that is ax square plus ay square. Okay, see, that makes okay, ax and ay, sometimes called the rectangular components vector A. Now see, where components are given, we have obtained the magnitude. Now see, what about the direction? See, ay upon ax is a sin theta upon a cos theta, so tan theta. So this will give the direction, tan theta is ay upon x. So what we have discussed, see, if a vector is given, we have obtained its component, that is any vector represented in terms of the unit vector. So here ax is a cos theta, that is a x component, okay, and ay is a sin theta, that is a y component of it. Now see, how do we use in the numerical? Okay, that we have to see. Now let us say angle is 60 degrees. Okay, now let us say x and y. Okay, now see, angle is 60 magnitude, so here ax is a cos theta, a is 10, cos 60. Okay, now ay is a sin theta, 10 sin 60 is root 3 by 2. Okay, pi root 3 or root 3 value is 1.732, you can simplify. Okay, so this is how when vector is given, we can divide into its rectangular component, that is x and y component. Now sometimes we are given the component and from that we have to obtain the value of the magnitude of the vector and direction also. So let us say an example. See, the x component of vector is 3 and y component of vector minus 4. Okay, find out magnitude and direction of it. Okay, now see, let us say vector is a. So what is the x component? You can say b, c, whatever you like. Okay, let us say a. So let us say bx is 3 and by, that is y component, x component is 3, y component is minus 4. Okay. Now vector v will become bx square plus by square, that is, okay. Now what about the direction? See, the tan theta is ay by ax, tan theta will be dy is minus 4. Okay, theta is Now see how we can represent on a plane. See here x component is 3 and y component is minus 4, that is in negative y direction. Okay, so what will be our resultant? Okay, now we can complete this rectangle. This will be the resultant vector, magnitude is 5 and theta is the angle. Okay, so this minus 4 by 3, okay, you can say theta is tan inverse 4 by 3, that is in, what is the quadrant here, first, second, third and fourth, okay, so that is in fourth quadrant, okay. So this is how any vector can be divided into its component, and if components of vectors are given, we can find out the magnitude of the vector, magnitude of the vector and direction. So this is about the rectangular component of vector. Now see, right now we have talked of component of vector in two dimension. Same way we can represent in a three dimension also. Okay, so any vector in three dimension can be represented as a, axi, ayj, azk. Okay, magnitude of the vector is ax squared plus ay squared. Okay, so in three dimension vector can be written into its components a, x, y and z under root ax squared plus ay squared plus az squared. Now in the beginning of the lesson we talked about position of vector. Okay, now see, the p is a particle whose position vector is op is r. Okay, so any vector r xy xi plus yj plus zk, okay, now see the magnitude of the vector is under root x squared plus y squared. Okay, so this is how, see, this ax, ay, az is a particular formula for vector a. See, r is a position vector, x I caret plus y j caret plus z k caret. See, its magnitude is denoted r, or you can write simply r, both have the same meaning. So this is how we can represent a vector into its component x, y and z. Now next we have to see the analytical method of the vector addition. Okay, next we have to see the analytical method of the vector addition. Let us say earlier method we proved r is equal to under root a square plus b square. Okay, in which only magnitude of the vector and the direction between two vectors was given. Here see, we are giving the vector in terms of the component. Let us say a is equal to axi plus ayj az k. Vector b has component bxi plus byj. Okay, so if I add two vectors a plus b, see, I caret, the component with the I caret I have to take together, so that will be ax plus bx I caret. Similarly, ay plus by j caret az plus bj. Okay, similarly for the vector subtraction, okay, a minus b, this will be difference of x component, y component, okay. So this is how we can add two vectors into its component in terms of the component, and we can subtract the two vectors into components. Let us say a is equal to 2i plus 3k plus 5k 3 is 3i minus 8j plus 3j. Now suppose we have to add two vectors, 3a plus b will be 2 plus 3 I correct. Here it is minus 8, so okay, so this will make 5i correct. 3 minus 8 is minus 5. Okay, now this is the addition of two vectors and the magnitude. Okay, now you can solve this. Similarly, a minus b, then we have to subtract the component. See here, 2 minus 3 will be minus I caret. 3 minus minus will become plus 11 j caret. 5 minus 3 will be 2 caret. Okay, 2 minus 3 will be minus I caret. 3 minus will become plus 11 j. 5 minus 3 is 2 caret. Now see the magnitude. Minus 1 square plus 11 square plus 2 square. Okay, so this is how we can perform addition and subtraction of two vectors. So sum of the components, that is ax plus bx I caret, ay plus by j caret, az plus bz j caret. Subtraction will be ax minus bx I caret, ay minus by j caret, az minus bz j caret. So this is about the vector addition and subtraction. See, these are very interesting topics. See, next time we'll take some example of this.